What's up, guys? Welcome to another video. My name is Sparkman. I'm a game developer. Today, we're going to create a health bar in Unreal Engine 4. Let's get started. Whoa, what is that on the floor? It says subscribe and like the video. It's here somewhere, but I can't find it. This is one of the default templates you get with Unreal Engine 4. This is the third-person template. And if you hit play, you can see that you can move, jump, and do all that kind of fun stuff. If you don't have Unreal Engine 4, download it. It's free. I'm going to go to the third-person folder. And let's go to Blueprint. Let's create a new widget under Interface, Widget, Blueprint. And let's call this Super Health. You don't have to call it Super Health. Let's double-click on it. And let's drag one of the progress bars. Let's make it bigger. This is going to be our health bar. Okay, so let's change the color. Let's make it green. You can make it whatever color you want. I like green for health bars for some reason. Green. Well, is that blue? Did I just make it blue? I think I did. Here's the percentage. You can see that the health bar moves. So let's save this. And let's open the third person blueprint. So I guess we can display the health bar. Let's do a event. Oops, there we go with the typing. Event begin play. This happens at the beginning of the game. And we're going to create a widget. Create widget, just like we did yesterday. And let's output this to the viewport. So add to viewport. Let's connect the target to the return value. Compile this. Error message. Okay, we have to select the class. I did this yesterday too. Super health. Let's compile again, and we're fine. Let's close it. Let's try it out. And you can see that we have a health bar. Wow, but it's empty. Let's fill the health bar. Let's return to the blueprint. And let's create two variables. We're going to call the first one full health. And let's make this a float. Let's make another one. And let's call this one... current health, and we're gonna make this a float, which is already a float. Okay, so let's compile this, and let's enter the value. It's gonna be 100, and full health is going to be 100 as well. Okay, so let's save this. Let's return to the widget, click on the health bar. Here is the percentage, here's the number. We're going to replace this for the two variables we just entered. Cast this to the third-person character. Third-person character. For the object, we're going to use player character. And now we can access those variables. Okay, so let's find full health. And let's find current health. We're going to divide this by current health. Okay, so let's do that. Divided float by current health. Let's connect this to the return node. Let's compile this, close this, and let's try it out. Whoa, now we have a full health bar. Wow, that was so easy. Now we just need to decrease the health bar by doing something, okay? Like a collision or pressing a button. Go to the first person character. I'm going to right click again, and let's press one of the keys. Let's try G. We're going to get a full health bar. I'm going to place a full health here, and let's subtract, say, 5 from this. Let's connect it to the health meter. Let's compile this, close it. Let's press G. Whoa, my health goes down. What is going on? Let's do the same thing with a collision. Okay, so let's go to volumes and let's drag a trigger volume. Okay, so when we walk into that volume, we are going to decrease his health. Make sure that the volume is selected. Double click on the blueprint. I'm going to right click and let's go to add event, collision on overlap begin. Let me just delete this here. If I'm pressing G, let's connect it to the health. Compile it. Close this. And let's try it out. Let's walk by the steps. Whoa! Our health goes down. Wow, that was so simple. Don't forget to subscribe, like the video, and I will see you in the next episode. Bye now.